what to do when you have a terrible horoscope, terrible placements, afflicted planets, planets in dosthana houses, planets in debility, planets in precarious states. Okay, so I was asked a question long back that I have a terrible horoscope and most of my dashas have been very miserable. And the antar dashas of those mahadasha planets which are yet to come are also miserable. They have been very miserable. So henceforth, maybe I come to this conclusion that the mahadashas of those planets will also be very miserable. So if you have had this experience, then please let me know in the comments. Yes, I know many of you, and me included in that, of course, we have this fear that what will happen, you know, this dasha will come, that time period will come, this will happen, that will happen. And there are terrible placements. And to add to that, there are so many things in India and in YouTube especially. Like, I keep getting these questions that I have Kalsarp Dosh, what will happen? Sade Sat is going on, what will happen? My Rahu is coming over my natal Venus, what will happen? Oh my God, Rahu has transited my 10th house, maybe my career is ruined. So today we will try our best to have a look at what to do when we have such terrible placements, so-called or apparently horrible or horrendous placements, as the people call it as. Alright, so there you go. If you are new to the channel and if you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your placements, good or bad, and if you want to know about certain future events of your life or about yourself in general, then you could go down to my website in the description section of this video and book a reading. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and you will find Him. So now what happens is, we know some basics of astrology. Most of the people in YouTube especially, we may know advanced stuff. We may be doing so many things, but we exactly do not come to know what actually is happening. So for example, people ask me that, let me give you some examples. So somebody is wanting to know about career. So what happens is, instead of knowing what is going to happen in your career, instead of knowing how to analyze the horoscope, what happens is, people, they see individual videos. For example, suppose somebody has Venus in the 10th house. So that person will see a video of XYZ astrologer in YouTube. Venus in 10th house, what happens? The person is interested in beauty, creativity. So the person should go into fashion designing. And let's talk with some examples. Suppose there is a Capricorn ascendant and his Venus is in Libra in the 10th house. So then he will see another video, Venus in Libra in Kendra. It's known as Malavya Mahapurush Yoga. So then he will see some videos about this yoga where they say all the great qualities of Venus are bestowed to this native. They will see videos where they will find inputs on the Dasamsa, the D10 divisional charts. So what happens is, then they will see that, okay, in D10, like, they will ask questions like this. Maybe you have also seen such questions. In the Dasamsa chart, my 7th Lord and 6th Lord are in Parivartan. So what is going to happen? So first of all, when we start learning astrology, it is highly essential that we keep in mind the purpose of it. The purpose of learning astrology is not to learn what Rahu Ketu is doing. It is not to learn if a Saturn is exalted in your chart. It is also not to know what Venus is doing. It is just simply to know what is going on in your life. And for that, you need a harmony. Harmony means you have to know to check how the planets are speaking in the tone of the horoscope. And that will happen only when you undergo systematic training in astrology. So when we do not do that, then we get very much bogged up by individual things. Like there was one person who mailed me recently. He said that in the Lagna chart, what happened was his 10th lord was in the 9th house. So according to him, this is a good placement. Now it is good or bad, that's a secondary question. But according to him, it is a great placement. Okay, 10th lord in the 9th. Then he said, but in my Dasamsa chart, the 10th lord is in the 8th house. So what will happen? So now my career will be good, my career will be bad. So now you see. See what happens when we individually try to analyze things. The biggest problem is you will never find a horoscope where everything is fine. You will never find it. At least I have not found yet. So then what happens is we take things too much personally, and rather than analyzing and understanding or going to an astrologer and asking, sir, madam, can you please explain me what is happening in my life, rather than asking what Venus is doing, what Saturn is doing, what Parivartan is there, what Raj Yoga is there, what Nij Bhanga is there, what Mahapurusha is there, rather than asking these questions, we should simply ask that, sir, madam, can you please tell me what is going on in my life? How can I improve my life? We do not do that. So, individually, we keep checking. We keep checking 10 things. And out of those 10, 99% of the times, 8 of them will be spoiled. And then we come to a conclusion. So, that's an incomplete conclusion which we come into. And by that, we gain anxiety of the future. So, If you are feeling that you are constantly getting this fear of what will happen if this dasha comes, what will happen if that dasha comes, then before you conclude that it's going to be a bad dasha, please cross-check with somebody who knows how to interpret dashas, okay? Otherwise, you may realize, suppose you think that Saturn Mahadasha will be miserable, then you come to know about this, or you think that it will be miserable when you are undergoing Rahu Mahadasha. For example, suppose for some reason your Rahu Saturn Antardasha was very bad. So you conclude Saturn will be very bad, my Mahadasha. And then Jupiter Mahadasha comes after Rahu for 16 years. So then whole 16 years, even if your Jupiter is good, I mean, good in the sense not exalted or in own sign, if actually your life has improved after Jupiter Mahadasha, then you will think that, oh, anyways, Jupiter is going to end after 16 years. Life will be hellish after 16 years, right? Because why? Because my Saturn Mahadasha is starting. Why it is bad? Because in Rahu, my Saturn was very bad. So Saturn has to be bad, right? But people do not know this simple concept that the Mahadasha Lord can change everything. What is the natural relationship of the Mahadasha Lord with the Antardasha Lord? Are they natural friends? Are they natural malefics? Are they functional malefics, or they are functional benefics? Where is the Lord of the Antardasha Lord placed from the Mahadasha Lord? These are questions which we need to ponder. What is the Ashtak Varga? How is that planet placed in the Navamsha? These are all questions which we do not ponder. And individually we try to analyze things. We categorize things as good and bad. So then comes the problem, you see. Then you do not understand the whole picture. You do not get the bird's eye view. And because of that, you come into wrong conclusions. But now say, suppose you have come to a good conclusion. Suppose, let's imagine that you came to a right conclusion, that suppose your Saturn Mahadasha is supposed to be very bad. Suppose, let's assume that you are right. So then what to do? Well, the free will is always there. Now, what is free will? I recently made a video on free will and destiny. So what is free will? Free will is basically to the extent you can change your karma. Yes, that is what they told you, right? No, that's not what free will. Free will is simply how you respond to your existing destiny, which is quote unquote so and so called unchangeable. You cannot change what is going to happen to you. You can only change the way you react, because that is under your free will. If somebody has done something bad to you, now you have the free will. Will I also end up doing bad for that person, or will I not? So that is one example. So what happens is, when you use your free will properly, then the destiny doesn't change, but your ability to cope up with that so-called screwed or terrible or horrible destiny gets better with time. Now, if you do not use your free will also properly, then it's like a double blow. It's like saying a person is there, suppose a person is there who will come and beat you, for example. And he beats you. And after beating you for 15 minutes, he leaves you. And you are in a pathetic situation. Now you go and start drinking alcohol, or you start go and smoking, or you go and eat meat. So that means what you are doing? You are already miserable by destiny. Now you are becoming more miserable by using your free will in a wrong way. But instead, suppose you take care, you go to the hospital or you go to the police station, whatever is required, you do. Then things get better with time. Now, this does not mean that if you do that, then the person who was supposed to come and beat you will not beat you. He will beat you. That you cannot stop. But how much that beating will affect you, that you can control to a very large extent. So the most important thing is, we have to just do what is in our hand. And for that, we need to use our free will properly. Because that is all that we have. Nothing else is there in our hand. And that's the best part. That is fully there in our hands. Fully means 100%. Nobody can take your free will away from you. Even Lord Vishnu does not do that. How in the universe, how the hell will somebody else do it? Yes, Krishna says in the Gita, Ishvara sarva bhutanam hriddeshe arjuna tishthati. Oh Arjuna, I am situated in everybody's heart. Now, he does not force you to use your free will. God does not even force you to worship him, to come to him. So if God does not force you, then who else can force you to use your free will in right or wrong ways? Nobody can force you. That's the good news. It is you who will decide what you will do with your free will. So that point has to be very clearly understood. And apart from that, you also have to make sure that your overall life is having a lot of sattva guna inside. Otherwise, if you are dancing in rajoguna and tamoguna, then things get really very bad. Then I have seen, have you seen people born in million and billion dollar families, they've ruined their lives completely. Now, this is an example of a great dasha and a terrible free will. This is one example. You will see many people, sons and daughters of politicians, big politicians, film stars, actors, actresses. Then you will see sports stars. These are all, you know, the cream crowd. You can see sometimes their sons and daughters, you know, they will have accidents, they will get into drugs. What is all this nonsense? They are having a great karma to enjoy, but they are enjoying in a wrong way. There are many good ways to enjoy life, not that you just go and do nonsense anywhere and anything, anywhere, anytime. Yes, that's the slogan. So when we have sattva guna inside us, then we can see things more clearly. So when sattva guna is there, then what happens? Suppose there is a terrible time, there is a very bad time, okay, so-called bad time. Your bad time has started, suppose. Then when sattva guna is there in you, mode of goodness is there, then you can see exactly to what extent is the problem there. Otherwise, if somebody is in tamoguna or rajoguna, then what happens? Something happens and they're like, oh my God, what will happen? Are kya hua? Kuch nahi hua. Nothing has happened. Why are you exaggerating the problem 10 times? The problem is there. But you already have 99 problems. Don't be the 100th. But sometimes we not only be the 100th, we be the 100th and 1000th. Yes, all the numbers. I don't know, this is also giving problem. So you see what happens? We magnify the problem. The mind shows us a horror movie. Oh my God, your Saturn Mahadasha has started. Your whole 19 years, you are going to be ruined. So if that happens to you, then it's a very clear and strong indication that you are in Tamoguna, in mode of ignorance. And you are also in Rajas. Rajas means thinking, overthinking. Kya hoga, ye hoga, wo hoga, this will happen, that will happen. Baith ja be. You have, see, nothing will go wrong. Chill. Just chill. But you cannot just chill if you are in Rajoguna and Tamoguna. You just cannot. You see people. And the extent to which I have seen people creating unnecessary fears, that's like way beyond. In fact, it's very interesting. One day a person messaged me that he's having some problems. So then I just said, okay, wish you all the best. Good luck. So now, this is a default response. Anybody, if you say that I'm having a problem, then anybody will wish you good luck. But then what that person wrote back to me was, it's very interesting what he wrote. He wrote to me that, oh, why are you saying good luck? Do you mean that my life is going to be ruined? That is why you are wishing me good luck. And then I was like, that's Tamoguna. Even if you see something good, you will take it in a wrong sense. In Mahabharata, we have the classic example of Duryodhan. Classic. He was such a fool that he tried to put chains over Lord Krishna's body. When Krishna came as Shantidut, he tried to do that. But of course, all his efforts went in vain and he could not succeed. But the point is, he thought that he can bind God. Why? Because he thought God was his enemy. Can you believe it? Why will God be somebody's enemy? But he thought it like that. So that's one of the examples from the scriptures. And around you can find many people, or maybe you can find yourself also. Sometimes. Alright, so we must ensure that we are having Sattva Guna in our life. And there are many ways to improve Sattva Guna in our life, to increase Sattva Guna. The first is, we have to eat sattvic food, which includes vegetarian food. So if you are eating meat, then that will put us more into Rajogun, more into Tamogun. Alright. So if we desire that one day we will go to Sattva Guna, then we must give up that from our diet. And I am extremely, extremely delighted. There are so many people who have messaged me, mailed me that by seeing your videos, we have decided to give up meat. I become very happy when I hear it. And that's one thing. Then you have to do daily spiritual practices within your life. You must read the scriptures like the Gita, the Srimad Bhagavatam. And I'm also delighted to know many people are reading. I'm very, very, very happy to know this. And you should get up early in the morning. You should take a good bath in cold water if possible, if your health allows. And then you should also meet people who are spiritually connected, who are spiritually elevated in the weekends, if possible. So when you do all this, then you will see Sattva Guna is increasing. And at the same time, distance yourself from people who engage in unnecessary talks of this mundane material world, like who is going to win the elections in India 2019, which cricketer is having affair with which Bollywood star. These are some of the questions which people waste their time pondering. Alright. And whenever you get chance, you share about spirituality, you share spiritual knowledge. So by that, your Sattva Guna will improve. And by that, you will be able to see things clearly, and you will know to extent which the so-called bad placements are there. So that is how we deal with the negative placements. Rather than trying all sorts of funny remedies, like for Saturn, they try remedies like feeding crows. Yes, putting, there are some people who put oil in their body. Can you believe it? They are going and eating meat, and they are going and watching pornography. And then you think that you will feed this crows, and you will put oil or tea in your body, and then you think that certain problems will vanish. Wow. If it was so easy, everybody would have done it, right? So there you go. The only solution is that we increase sattva guna in our body, and by that we deal with the negative placements which are there in the horoscope. All right. So there you go. If you are new, then please like, comment, share and subscribe. Hit the thumbs up. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your good or bad placements, then you could go to my website down to book a reading. You'll find the link to the website down in the description section of my videos. Okay. Until next time, wish you good luck. Bye bye. See you.